Straight up, now tell me, do you really wanna love me forever? Oh, oh, oh. Or is it just a hit and run? Hey, we got a good thing. Don't know if I'ma see you again.
Recording a little late in the afternoon, so if my camera is moving a little slow with my actions, that's why. So it's another Thursday in October, which means it's Thriller Story Thursday, and I'm really, really, really excited to tell you guys about this story. And also, something happened to me last night as well that was pretty scary. Not enough to like make a video of it, but I'll talk about it at the end of this video, you know? Okay, I love Thriller Story Thursdays. They're just so much, they're so fun. You know, Thriller Story Thursdays are really fun, so I'm really happy I could do this for you guys. If y'all have not seen the first episode of Thriller Story Thursday of this year, please go check it out. It's up there. Go click it for me and go watch it. It's a little lengthy, but that's because the beginning of it, I had announcements and stuff, so you could always skip to the actual story portion. And as always, gotta have my candle lit. Gonna really come up in here now. I don't have time for that, okay? So let's get into Thriller Story Thursdays. Okay, so if you don't know, if you didn't get a chance to watch my recent Thriller Story Thursday, please go check it out. Basically, it was about a ghost who pushed me while I was asleep. It was very scary. It was the first time I've ever had anything paranormal happen to me physically to the point where I was touched. So it was a very new experience that I never want to experience again. And so this happens like 2 weeks after that. So I was sleep. I was sleep deprived, as always. Again, you guys, I don't sleep, okay? Like, for real. Like, I mean that. I don't go to bed. So I was getting ready to take a nap. And usually I have my TV on. But this run, I didn't have my TV on. Specifically, I had my door open. Just in case, so that I could hear if my folks had came in the house. It was dead silent. You know, maybe you heard the roll, maybe you heard my fan or something. But other than that, it was silent. So I was asleep for just a couple seconds, right? And something had said something to me. It was three words. Three of the scariest words I've ever heard in my life. Oh, I'm shaking my leg. I wonder if I'm shaking. Three of the scariest words I've ever heard in my life. And it sounded like it was dead ass in my ear. So I'm turning this way. I'm asleep. Got my eyes closed. And all I heard was, "Are you asleep?" Bitch! I was like, now hold on. Hold up, okay? I don't have time for this, you know? Last week you touched me. You put your hands on me. And now you asking me if I'm asleep? What I'm going to need you to do, Mr. and Mrs. Ghost, y'all need to get out of my house. Y'all need to get out of my room, at least. Let me go to bed. Why are you trying so hard to not let me go to sleep? So I jump up, of course. I jump up initially, wake up, look around my surroundings. Ain't nobody there. And I just don't, I'm like, what's going on? What's happening? And I just remember asking the good Lord himself, don't let nothing happen to me, please, because it started getting scary. Like, it was already scary, but it really started getting really scary. Like, you got people whispering to me now. I'm not finna deal with this. What's happening? What's going on? You know, is this a ghost or is this my mental trying to freak me out? Which is like a scary process to think, like, maybe I was that tired that I imagined somebody saying something to me. But I don't think so, because it just felt so real. It sounded so real. So I don't know what's going on. I don't know if it was real or if it was sleep deprived talking to me. Because, you know, sometimes whenever you have lucid dreams, everything can feel real even when you wake up. So I don't know if that's what was going on, if that's what was happening. But it was really scary. It was terrifying. And I had never wanted it to happen to me again, especially since I heard the person clear as day. And there's no reason for nothing to be haunting me. Like, even if the house was haunted, we're the first ones to own this house. We made this house, kind of thing, you know? So we're not on no what them things, them movies, the Indio burial grounds. We're not under nothing like that. But it's just really scary, especially considering the fact that I recently talked to my mom and she was like, remember, you used to see things all the time. And you used to say you heard things all the time. See, that's where parents don't be saying nothing. Like, what? You heard your child say that there was an entity in the bathroom and you ain't go check it out? Like, that's how everybody be dying in the horror movies, okay? Listen to the kids. That was really it. But, you know, it was still really scary to, if you just sit there and think about that you heard somebody say something to you, knowing damn well ain't nobody home who's talking to you. And then, was it last night? It was last night, two nights ago. I was at work. And I was at work for a long time. Whenever I came home, I was tired. When I fell asleep on the couch, and my door was kind of open, you know, it was pitch black in my room, but the light was on in the living room and stuff, and I fell asleep on the couch. And I heard something upstairs drop, okay? Like, dead ass. Heard something upstairs drop, and it woke me up. And I looked around, and I looked this way, and I looked in the darkness of my room, and it looked like somebody was standing there. I have never been so scared in my life. And I thought somebody pushing me was scary. I thought hearing somebody was scary. But now I feel like I done seen something. And that's just a whole other level. You know, they're really trying to go with this census thing. Like, you know, touch, hear, and see. I don't have time for that, you know. It's just, it's really terrifying. And I'm like, is that the same thing that's been talking to me? Is that the same thing that then pushed me? Like, what's going on, you know? So, it scared the shit out of me. It really did. Like, I felt my heart drop. You know whenever something scares you in your heart? I hate living by a road. You know whenever something scares you in your heart, like, drops to your stomach, and it's kind of painful a little bit. You're kind of like, oh. And that's kind of how it happened. So, I, like, blinked a couple times and looked back and didn't see anything. So, I want to assume it's because I was tired and maybe I just woke up. Maybe my eyes were playing tricks on me. I don't know. I keep assuming things. The next time I do a video, y'all going something's going to happen in the video. I'm going to be on the ceiling or something like that, you know. Please don't. No thanks. But, you know, yeah. And I went upstairs to go check out what the noise was. And my dad was awake and he said he didn't hear anything. And I'm like, okay. All right. But I noticed that all of the ghostly things that happen whenever I'm tired or something. Nothing has happened whenever I'm, like, wide awake. Like, oh, I'm here. I'm living. I know what's happening right now. But nothing ever happens. So maybe it's all an illusion that my brain is playing with me. But I don't know. It's really scary and it's terrifying and I don't like it and I need to stop, like, immediately. So yeah, that was my story. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Again, if there's anything paranormal that's ever happened to y'all, or if y'all get what I'm saying and everything like that, or if y'all think it's scary or whatever, please let me know. Comment. Tell me what you think. So yeah, I wish you to see y'all next time. Remember, keep your head up and smile and always let somebody has your back. Bye! We can make it.